everybody, each one of us would like to work with a pleasant and a happy client, right? Because those people are a positive energy creator for us. We feel inspired to work along with us. But this is not the story all the time, right? So during my career, I have faced many clients. Being an IT professional for last more than 10 years, I have faced clients across the globe, and there have been various types of them. Some being very supportive, some being very understanding. Suppose you are in a situation where you are not able to give them a proper solution, they will guide you through, right? So in that scenario, we feel really blessed. Like, you know, the people are there to understand us. And this will help us to work learning phase of, this is a good learning phase for us as being in support or being in QA or maybe as an agency owner or, you know, as a freelancer or maybe as a company owner. You maybe might be having your own employees. So while process was going on, there are a few things which I have learned, and today I'm going to share with all of you all those little lessons which I have learned, and I hope that you will implement in your career ahead.
So yeah, successfully dealing with difficult clients.
So this is a skill actually. If this skill will make you more influential and happy in your career. So if you develop this skill, this will help you in a lot way, apart from being a professional also. All love to work with them. They are not much trouble actually. You know, it's a smooth sail. You can sail and all the phases of the project. Or maybe if you're in support or you know, in any other aspect as a developer or a QA clients. So I'd like to know how many of you are having experience of 100% happy clients, 100% client satisfaction, 100%. You know, as a product service provider, so that is actually next to impossible, because all of us are unique. All of us are unique. So definitely the problem which we're going to face will be unique. So it is an endless learning process. But the key is to keep on learning and understanding the basics. So yeah, we can sort out their problems by understanding them. My name is Anju Abhilash, and it's been quite some time. I have various feathers in my cap. I've been a trainer, I've been QA, and presently I'm working as a freelancer. And in all these scenarios, I have actually, you know, learned quite a few good lessons. Very good lessons. Categorize the clients in four parts. This is how I have categorized. The first one is the penny pincher
or the cheap
clients, who are basically how much it will cost. The moment you pick up the call, or the moment you get a niche over something, like the moment the tip of the project is going to come, they will ask you how much it will cost. Price kya hoga? Kitna price aap lenge? They are least bothered what value you are going to provide them, or how much that value is going to, you know, build their objective, their business, their whatever the motto is in life. So they are least bothered about the product, the quality, nothing. They are not interested. And even if suppose you, okay, let's give it a start. If you aren't in this mode, they will be like, continuously, they will be like, you know, isme agar ye bhi add ho jayega, kitna acha hai. Achha, mujhe laga isme saath hi added hai. Aap ye bhi provide karenge iske saath? This will be, I think it is like feature hoga. This is like, ye sab isme inbuilt nahi tha. ये तो आपका कुछ ज्यादा प्राइस जा रहा है ये अगर हम उसको उस स्कोप में डिफाइन करते हैं उसके बावजूद भी सो लाइक एवरीथिंग व्हाट एवर दे टॉक अबाउट और व्हाट एवर वी वेन एवर कम्युनिकेट विद देम दे ऑलवेज आर इन अ मोड ऑफ अ मनी माइंडेड सेट यू कैन नॉट टेक देम अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट लेवल
दीज क्लाइंट्स आर angry always, they are in an anger mode always, they are intolerable, they are inefficient in many aspects also, and then they are demanding all the time, they are so much talkative. When I say talkative, they just keep on talking, they never listen, they never let you listen on, they never want to listen to you actually, they are into always You know, this negative aura is around them. The moment you come to know that there is going to be a call with them, you feel so drained and there is this negative energy and aura which is always there. They never smile. They are never in a pleasant mood. So before talking to them or in any interactive mode, whenever we go, have an interaction with them, so that aura, that energy come across to us also. So very difficult people to actually handle. Most of our business owners, agencies, or people who are in freelancing, and developers who are working apart from the regular job, they most of the times are targeting these two clients indirectly actually. Indirectly, they are targeting these two clients indirectly. But actually, if you need to have a smooth sale in respect of your profession, in respect of your business, we need to focus the thing in these two fields. That is the sophisticated and affluent. Now, who are sophisticated clients? Now, these clients are very educated. They are abreast of the technology. They know what they want, and they are a good listener. They, if you try to educate them, they are good learners and they will appreciate that. And they will also provide us some knowledge which build the trust, which is the most important aspect while going through the journey of creating a project. So in be it phase one till the client, last phase of project, between the beta delivery of the product. So these clients are basically, it's a two-way, like they will also learn and grow and we will also learn along with them. So this is a very good set of clients which we all of us would like to have. They are, then the next one is affluent. Affluent clients are basically, they work on feeling. Does that particular product is going to make them feel good or not? Or whatever the service which they have acquired for. So that is how they think. For example, in this room only, there must be a set of people who would like to go for a certain kind of mobile, and there would be a certain group which will be like, I don't want this mobile, this doesn't make me feel good, as in whatever the criteria is, and they will go for the other thing, irrespective of the features. They don't want to get trained with the features, they are not bothered about the money also. So it is affluent clients are basically who are take decisions based on feelings. So these are the four major clients which we have. Now, difficult clients. Whenever we know that the difficult client is going to communicate with us, we know that there is something which is going to, come up, and we are in a alert mode. So there is this website which I want to develop. I'm a very difficult client, and I want to develop this website. I don't have much money. I don't have time also. I don't know what is it, but I don't want this. I don't want this, and I want to create. I want you to create a website which should be next to Amazon or Hotstar, and with a logo of Spider-Man. So I want it to be very good. Okay, so, but I don't have time. Since we have talked today only, I know that a website can be created in minutes or maybe in an hour. So by what time you're going to deliver me? A difficult client will be talking to you in that way. So we are at work, we are doing our best. We are just working so hard. So it was actually 10 seconds, but oh. So like why didn't you complete it in 12 seconds? Like you wasted my time. And for a QA, that will be the beta version. If the client really trips off. So there is an emergency. There is always an emergency. And whatever you deliver to them, the product, they are never satisfied. They always have one or two other things which, you know, they'll creep upon. And then it will definitely, there will be a stage where we'll regret why we have taken a decision, a good decision to, you know, work with these clients. So this is how it goes. So now the client journey. We all like to have a client which is happy. But then with a happy client also, it is not like a straight ECG line where there is no, everything is like they have thought of something, we have thought of something, and it is going to be, you know, a straight ECG line with no ups and downs. No, there will be many ups and downs in affluent client, in educated, sophisticated client, and in respect of your, you know, the penny pinchers also. There will be ups and downs. You know, we'll take care of with the penny pinchers. We can again keep on negotiating time factor and lot many other things, since they are not as into technical things. So we can keep on working with that. So it is never going to be easy with the other three clients which we have talked about. That is the penny pinchers, the affluent, and the sophisticated one. But see, with some of your clients it will be like this. Some with a few ups and downs, with others it will be more ups and downs, you know, so it will be a journey, a good journey, I would say. But with difficult clients, since beginning, your heartbeat will be, you know, on a pitch that will, you know, never be in a settling mode. So it will be a difficult ride for you. Yes, be patient. The difficult clients are a fact of life. With them, don't waste your time treating the symptoms while ignoring the disease. The best thing which we can do is prevention. How we can prevent? Being a freelancer, being a IT agency or a IT business owner or as a developer, how we can sense as a marketing or sales team in the company, how we can sense, how we can prevent a difficult client? Because we know the end result is not going to be good with them, so it's best to the approach to make it as a in a preventable thing. So the first thing is how to prevent them. So the prevention is the best methodology with difficult clients. Okay, we need to examine them first. We need to know what is their target client is. So the first thing we need to know, and we need to understand their niche as well as our niche and their worth and skill. We need to analyze our worth and skill, what we are able to deliver to our clients. It should not be an open-ended development company or a freelancer or a service provider. You know, you are agreeing for an architecture work also, and you are agreeing for a doctor's work also as a content writer. There should be a niche on which your thought process can work well. So you should not, the first thing is, you should be able to understand your own skill niche, and the other thing is you need to understand what exactly they are into. Now, whenever you, after this, the second is the gut feeling. The moment you interact with them, you will have sense that it is not a good deal going to be. You will come to know it. The moment you will interact with them, or there might be an uncertainty of maybe or may not be, but there will be sometimes when you meet a certain people or the team from which you are going to get the project, you know at the very instant that it is going to be a good deal. The moment you interact with them, you know, that there is that click, yes, this is going to be a good start. Maybe there may be chances that it might go in a sore state of situation, but then in the very first thing you definitely feel yes, yaar is kaam karne wale log ke sath acha rahega, a good cooperative work environment along with this. So gut, definitely you need to read those signals. Marketing, in your website you need to upload whatever your target is, your skill is, your process basically, how you work in your company or as a freelancer, what are your objectives, what are your targets. So upload everything on your website so that there is a scene in the client's mind. He is not coming all blind to you when approaching to you. He will have that seed will be planted in his mind that yes, this is what I can expect from these guys as a service provider. So market yourself, your work on your websites with maximum of FAQ, the process which you follow, the kind of work which you deliver. So that will be definitely a good thing for prevention. The second thing is pre-qualification onboarding lessons. Now, there is this request for proposal form. Make it as detailed as possible. What they work on, what is their requirement, what were their challenges in the past, and what are their challenges in present. What is their marketing budget, what is their timeline, what is their complete budget for the whole project. So that is, and make it as detailed. The timeline is very important. They are into also service industry, they are going to get the service from you guys. So you need to know the marketing budget also, because we are not going to do that part. So they need to have that. We are not supposed to do that. If that is part of the project and the whole scenario, it should be included in the scope in the very beginning. Because again, the money factor will come and that will source. So these guys will, this section of clients will again trip on that. So include and define in that request for proposal form every aspect and try to basically understand them as much as possible. The more you understand them, it will be easy for you whether you are going to be able to deliver what they actually require. You know, that will be as much as detailed it will be as much as easy for you. I would say try to create a client avatar. You know, where you can actually visualize them. That avatar will let you know the inside out of the team which you're going to work with, the client which you're going to work with. And that avatar will help the people who are in the back end, who have never interacted with the client. So when they are, let's suppose they are in the QA aspect, the QA will come to know ki yaar isme ye itna chik-chik kar sakta hai. Ya fir client support mein hai to support wala, theek hai, iske pehle mail dalni hai, uske baad isse baat karni hai. Skype call aa raha hai to kitna avoid karna hai, kab usko Skype call ko lena hai, group mein lena hai, kaise. To wo ek avatar when you create that is so clear, which is very clear and perfect, then you know it will be a whole together an easy sale for you and your team. So this has to be a proper detailed one. The more it is detailed, the more it is easy for you. Road mapping consultation. Provide them a PowerPoint presentation. If suppose you have taken them, okay. The first thing is to avoid actually, but then let's suppose if you have taken them, okay, chalo, main iska kaam le leta hu, uske baad dekhenge. First ek phase ho jata, uske baad let's see ki maybe he will appreciate my work, he will value my work, the team will appreciate it, and they will, you know, give me a good feedback. But with these guys, actually, it is not possible because they are like, they work on all the aspects to make your life hell, because since they can't look into the optimistic or the positive part of it. So it is actually quite difficult. So yeah, in this road mapping, you can provide them a preview of what all and how the phase is going to happen. And if they are interested in, they can pitch in and they can shed some money to proceed with the first phase of the project, and which is good for you. This will help. But this is only possible once you have created that request for proposal form, that proper avatar is there. attracted them, then you have made them clear your process and your niche and your skills very clear to them. This phase will only come after that. Because if those first two phases are not clear, I don't think you will get the feel to have this consultation session with them. And until that, two things are not clear to you, because you need to target your things and you need to understand your own. Because see, the client is going to, no matter how much we market, the client is the one who brings it, you know, organic clients, real clients. Let's suppose a web page or other social media inbound or outbound marketing things are there in our system when we are working. So those things may bring you maybe one client or something, but then if a proper client product is delivered properly, our service has been delivered properly to the client, then that client, organic client, will give you more clients, the word of publicity, the goodwill which you create in the market, that will help you more in respect of having more clients. Or maybe that client will may come back ahead in future also. So yeah, and he will recommend that also. So if we actually develop the skill to handle the difficult clients, they are actually good. So it's very important for us to deal with them rather than avoiding them, totally avoiding them. You know, so yes, the road mapping is important. Pricing, be very clear on your pricing aspect. Why? Because we are all into 100% business, and we are not doing any charity or funded thing. So when the pricing aspect comes, be very firm and clear about your services and tell them it is effective and a priceless thing which you are going to deliver. So pricing is very important with them. Practice and make realistic approach. The moment the project has been started, and suppose there are some things which you feel that, you know, they are not satisfied with, and they are shooting mails after mails. You just had a mail conversation with them, and again you received another, then another. So in that case, talk with the team, and then with the whole proper opinion and with the proper time slot. If the client is in a very not in a good mood, or maybe swearing or shouting also. So in that case, define a timeline. But that timeline should be a proper timeline. It should not be something, acha, sham ko ho jayega, or we will revert to you by end of day. इस तरह से नहीं होना चाहिए अगर, क्योंकि ऐसा होगा तो जिसको इतना गुस्सा ऑलरेडी आ रहा है कि तुमको इतना पैसा दिया, टाइम दिया, तुम झूठ बोला, तुम्हारा टीम ऐसा ही है, व्हाटएवर, तुमने 15 का टीम बताया, 10 का टीम बताया, यू आर टॉकिंग टू मी लाइक दिस. सो वो आपने झूठा टाइमलाइन अगर उसको दिया है तो इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क. डोंट ट्राई टू बी कि ये बस एंड ऑफ द डे हो जाएगा, और डोंट शूट अ मेल कि इट विल बी रिस्पॉन्डेड और इट विल बी टेकन केयर ऑफ एंड ऑफ द डे. जस्ट होल्ड ऑन. Talk to the people who are there, your leadership, the team who are actually going to have. Because if it is a showstopper, it is not going to be sorted out in a seconds. It is going to take. So whatever timeline you are providing, provide it a proper one, so that the thing is being sorted, it is being tested properly, and then only deliver. So otherwise, it will escalate. That argument, that level of dissatisfaction will escalate only. Listen and let the client win. If it is a face-to-face thing or a mail thing, just let them vent out. Let them hear. Because, and if it is some kind of bad words are being used in Skype call, and it is on a your conference room, and the client is at his full pitch, listen. The thing which works is, listen, it is a very good tactic. Don't go after the words, don't go or think about what all it is being said in front of my juniors, in front of my seniors. Don't go with the terminologies, just listen. Because it is not personal thing, maybe you have never met face to face, but then it is about the dissatisfaction and why that complaint has come to you. Why? Because he is expecting, the team is expecting some solution from you. So the best is, let the client vent out and just listen to what exactly is the problem, rather than going with the terminologies. Ki tum mujhe kya bol diya abhi batata hu. Is tarah ka cheez nahi hona chahiye. Don't try to give respond, because the moment you respond or you try to win, you are lost, because that is not our objective. Is our objective is to find out the concern or the issue and sort it out. If the client is rude, apologize properly to the client. Admit if there is nothing you can do. If you cannot do anything about it, write a mail or on like face to face. We have tried to help you as much as we can, but there is nothing more we can do ahead now. Accept it and let the clients also know about it. You don't have to fake it. If you don't have the resource for it, if you think that a resource can be taken care of in maybe 1 or 2 days, then you can say so. But if you think that it is not in your limit, just clearly tell them. Don't let them hang over there. You know, it is not good, because that will be wasting hours and the time actually. The time of both the parties. So, angry clients on call, whenever they are at their full page, you have to remain calm. You don't have to take it personally, and you use your best listening skills and try to understand basically what they are trying to communicate or where is exactly they are having the trouble. Just sympathize. Sympathize doesn't mean like, I'm so sorry. This is not sympathizing. You need to say, I apologize for all the inconvenience which you and your team is going through. Because sorry, what it says, ho gaya, bas khatam. Sorry matlab you're not understanding, you're not trying to connect with what exactly the client is trying to tell you. Sorry, the moment you say it, it means usne jo bhi kuch kaha hai, aapne suna hi nahi hai. Sorry, agar aapne bol diya jaisa, iska matlab you have not understood. Because but if you try, yes, I do understand. I am so apologetic about this, and I'll try to sort this concern as early as possible. So that is a more better way. Don't use this term as far away actually. Find a solution. Whatever the solution you have, try to find a solution of it and give them a time frame. So how will you try to tackle it? An angry client, if it is a face-to-face, again, you need to listen to the client, understand what he is trying to say. You need to remain calm and adjust your mindset. And separate your feeling from the situation. Aapko kitna hi gussa aa raha hai, you're not supposed to let that feeling out. Usko hame indirectly ya directly koi comment nahi dena hai. Hame sirf usko receive karke us problem ko solution dena hai, rather than ki uske ek comment ke 10 jawab soch ke indirectly call ko end karte samay ek chota sa pinch dena hai. Ye nahi hona chahiye kabhi bhi, because that they are going to get that thing. That this is a backfire. वो कभी नहीं होना चाहिए. We are service providers और हमें अपनी कंपनी, we need to run the company for other 100 more years. So we have a vista view about our company for to run it for the next 100 years. So keeping that in mind, all those things in mind, try to respond in your communication. Conclusion is, they are actually very valuable for us, difficult clients. They are very valuable for us. They actually help us to grow as a service provider. So never try to actually avoid them. Listen to them and try to deliver your best with more value, which can add to their objectives and their values. So I'd like to quote over here. Peter Ducker, and it says, efficiency is doing things right, effectiveness is doing the right things. So let's be more effective. Thank you so much.
Starting the requirement and purchase order proposal jo fill karte hai, to uske baad purchase order hota hai, usme sari requirement likhi jati hai, itni requirement hai, itna amount hoga, itni timeline hai. तो एज अ इंडिविजुअल, एज अ फ्रीलांसर, इसी को कोई प्रोजेक्ट मिलता है तो एज अ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन उसको कैसे हैंडल करें. इट मीन्स कि मैं फ्रीलांसर हूँ एंड मैं कोई प्रोजेक्ट ले रहा हूँ क्लाइंट के पास, तो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में जैसे हैंडल होता है वो मैं एज अ इंडिविजुअल कैसे हैंडल करूँ.
व्हाई? बिकॉज इन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन यू हैव टीम्स, मार्केटिंग टीम, सेल्स टीम, द लीडरशिप इज देयर टू टेक केयर ऑफ द थिंग्स, to understand the whole cycle which is going to happen. They monitor if you are the team is doing a little incorrect thing, they will फटाफट से वो आपको बताएंगे कि नहीं इसको तो ऐसे कर. बट जब आप अपने एक रूम में बैठ के एज अ फ्री लांसर योर यू हैव एन प्रोजेक्ट एंड दिस सच डिफिकल्ट क्लाइंट इज देयर, इट इज मोर चैलेंजिंग. सो आई एम रिकमेंड यू टू गो फॉर अ डिटेल्ड, एज आई टोल्ड यू, अ डिटेल्ड रिक्वेस्ट फॉर प्रपोजल फॉर्म, बिकॉज दैट विल हेल्प यू टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड क्रिएट अ क्लाइंट अवतार. बिकॉज इफ दैट इज नॉट देयर, देयर इज, बिकॉज वी आर नेवर गोइंग टू इंटरेक्ट in person and you will be the only source for them. So try to send them a link, let them have it should be a detailed one with all your insecurities also, so they will fill it up. If they are not filling it up or avoiding it, they are not the one for you.
And what's the better, like email to pura conversation kare ya audio call ya video call?
Avoid video calls because that will let them know your region, you know, and then because there are, we live in, all of us, we know how the world is going on. So and then your choices, your lot many other aspects which are there invisible. If it is required, then you may, but if it is not required, why go for a video call? The second thing is, you can, after the mail and the communication is done, you can definitely go for a proper call. Yes, a detailed elaborate call as much as before taking the project. Go take as many as calls. If you feel that it is something which is not going to a right person or a team to pitch in, so take as many as calls. Because with that calls only you come to know the patient level of the other person and you will understand their psyche to deal with their service providers, how they have interacted with their past service providers, that is how they will talk to you, communicate to you. So if they are mature enough, they will definitely respond nicely and properly to all the calls which you are making to them.
Thanks.
अब जब नॉन टेक्निकल क्लाइंट आपकी डिफिकल्ट कैटेगरी में आता है तो आपकी क्या बेस्ट एडवाइस है उसको हैंडल करने की?
जब नॉन टेक्निकल क्लाइंट
आपकी डिफिकल्ट कॉलम में आ जाता है कि वो डिफिकल्ट बन गया है आपके लिए हैंडल करना, तो आप उसको कैसे टैकल करेंगे या उसको कैसे हैंडल करेंगे?
द क्लाइंट इज नॉट अवेयर ऑफ हाउ वी वर्क, सो वी नीड टू मेक हिम अवेयर. आई हैव टोल्ड यू टू थिंग्स, वन इज बाय मार्केटिंग ऑन योर वेबसाइट, sending him the link of request for proposal form, create a detailed one, a very detailed one. The things which he is trying to avoid, ask them all those things in call or in mail, that I have sent you this link and in these 3-4 start the timeline, the process and your budget, these three things have not been taken care of or you have ignored or you have not defined it, so I'd like to know more about it. Let him answer it.
Okay.
Push him to answer, to respond, because that is the area where he is going to screw you up, yeah, later. So it's better that you make him write those things.
Actually, I am just running a software firm.
Okay.
And I have a team of 20 people.
Okay.
So sometimes what happened, I have a retaining client, like to whom I am just working for some 3 to 4 years. Okay.
Okay.
And sometimes what happens, my team just made a small mistake and client just being so angry and they just want to fire us. Like even though we are working for 3 to 4 years, for just small mistakes, they are just trying to fire us and they just give us a last warning and all that. Like see, this is what and this is what not I am paying for you and all that. So we will stop working. So at that time, how we can convince them, like, see, we have worked for 3 to 4 years and for such a small things you are just leaving us and all that. How we can convince them?
It's been how long you are working with them?
Minimum 4 years.
4 years,
yeah,
now.
Yeah.
So you are running a agency,
yeah,
a company,
yeah,
with 10 to 15 people.
Yeah.
So those 10 to 15 people in 4 to 5 years, are this, is this team is same?
No, like
it is changing.
Yeah.
Your team is changing.
Yeah.
Okay. On the other end, is the team is same? Your client team is same?
Client.
They are almost same.
Yeah.
Okay. Now what happened over here, which I guess maybe I'm not right about it. The time, the kind of service, the quality of service which your dedicated team, which was there 2 or 3 years back, you know, they were actually working very sincerely and very hard. You shouldn't have let them go. They were, and the client and the team has not been changed. They are used to that dedication, that effort, that sincerity which your team delivered. So that is what is pinching them.
We need to maintain.
Now, what you can do is, the first is, you know, you have to maintain them. Train your team, and try to guide them. You know, motivate them with your efficiency and with your hard work. Not directly कि मैं 36 घंटे काम करता हूँ तुम चार घंटे करके चले जाते हो WhatsApp करते हो खाना चार घंटे खाते हो picnic भी चाहिए तुम्हें not like this. But you show your caliber, how much you determined are, or maybe there might be some people in your company who are actually, you know, since there when you started. So you three or four of you guys, you take some new skills to develop trust. Once you develop that trust, ask your team to work in a certain, you know, in a manner in which the client will be happy again.
जो भी जो 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 टाइम पे वो इतना गुस्सा करता है तब हमें कैसे काम डाउन करना
उस टाइम पे यू नीड टू एक्चुअली लिसन टू देम एंड व्हाटएवर सॉल्यूशन यू आर ट्राइंग टू गिव देम या वो जिस चीज से क्रिप कर रहे हैं उस देयर मस्ट बी थ्री थिंग्स और देयर माइट बी टू थिंग्स और देयर माइट बी वन थिंग ऑन व्हिच दे आर क्रिपिंग जॉट इट डाउन ऑन द पीस ऑफ पेपर आस्क व्हाट आर द थिंग्स कलेक्ट ऑल द मेल्स Record all the calls which you have done till now and try to find out there might be 3-4 things on which they are cribbing. Jot it down and select a path. There must be a navigation and you might be knowing how to sort it out. I'm sure you might be knowing. You might be knowing how to sort it out. So work on it on an emergency basis if you really want them to be able to do it.
Project management experience, I lean to develop delivery manager since last 2 years. So mostly as a delivery manager, I was looking a client who actually difficult, right? So jab bhi koi escalation aata hai, tabhi wo case mere paas aata hai. Otherwise, generally was supposed to be on a smooth way. So aapki whole session mein, I think mere do point mujhe lag rahe ki I'm add kar sakte hain. Ek cheez after experience I learned ki hum jitna bhi transparent rehte hain client ke saath. ईच एंड एवरी लेवल ये क्लाइंट डिफिकल्ट क्यों होते हैं बाई नेचर होते हैं या तो फिर वो अपने कुछ एक्सपीरियंस से होते हैं या हम प्रोजेक्ट की डिलीवरी के कौन से स्टेज पर है वैसे वो होते हैं डिलीवरी स्टेज पर होते हैं इनिशियली कोई क्लाइंट टफ नहीं होता है स्टार्टअप टाइम के कोई नहीं होता है राइट सो वो सब सिनारियों को मिला के एक चीज़ है अगर हम जितना भी ट्रांसपेरेंट रहते हैं क्लाइंट के साथ जितना भी हो सके इतना वो बफर कुछ नहीं होता है फ्रेंकली स्पीकिंग वो नहीं होता तो जितना ट्रांसपेरेंट रहेंगे वो हर चीज़ का सिनारियो वो समझेगा कहाँ पे डेवलपर एक्चुअली स्ट्रगल कर रहा है कहाँ पे एक्चुअली सर्वर प्रॉब्लम है कहाँ पे हमारी स्किल का प्रॉब्लम है कहाँ पे हम लोग इम्प्रूवमेंट कर रहे हैं ये रियली मैटर करता है और इससे हम लोग उनका एंगर एक लेवल पर कंट्रोल कर सकते हैं
करेक्ट
सो दैट इज़ वन थिंग सेकेंड थिंग और हैबिट इट इज वी जनरली कीप इन टच विद क्लाइंट वैन इट्स डिलीवरी टाइम जब हमारा माइलस्टोन या स्प्रिंट डिलीवरी होती है उस टाइम पर बट माई होल एक्सपीरियंस इज हम लोग डिलीवरी टाइम पर मिलते हैं उससे पहले बीच में फ्रिक्वेंटली ऐसे हाई हेलो किया क्या कर रहे हैं क्या आपकी बेटी है क्या वहाँ भी उनका प्रेजेंटेशन चल रहा है ये वो अच्छा ये कल हमारी डेवलपर ने बहुत अच्छा काम किया ये है आपके प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजर का आप बेनिफिट बताओ उनके प्लस पॉइंट बताओ सो क्लाइंट विल अप्रिशिएट क्लाइंट विल अंडरस्टैंड कि हाँ ये लोग हार्डवर्क भी कर रहे हैं एंड साथ साथ में रिलेशंस भी बन रहे हैं सो एंड जो भी सपोज कुछ डिले होने जा रहा है या कुछ गड़बड़ हो गई है सो इसी टाइम पर बता दो उसी टाइम पर बता दो कि ये गड़बड़ हो गई है बट वी आर वर्किंग ऑन इट रात दिन देखे बिना उसको बता दो कि वी हम कर रहे हैं सो ट्रांसपेरेंसी एंड कीपिंग टच विद क्लाइंट ऑल्सो विल हेल्प उनका एंगर एक लेवल तक कंट्रोल करने के लिए
If you like greet them on a certain time, like they are very, though they are difficult, but then they are tough to manage also. But then if you greet them, they will appreciate that. But here, if it is happening, like suppose we have Eid or Diwali or our own things, if they are not greeting us, so don't take it to the heart.
Yeah.